It's the E-Commerce Minute, your daily dose of e-commerce, tech, and retail news with your hosts, Bart Meraz and John Suter. The E-Commerce Minute is a production of Sumo Heavy, a digital commerce consulting firm in Brooklyn, New York, and Philadelphia. Find us on the web at sumoheavy.com. It's E-Commerce Minute, episode 349.
In today's episode, Facebook debuts small business pop-ups at Macy's.
Facebook is opening a series of pop-up stores in select Macy's stores this holiday season. They're the latest digital brand to test the waters in bricks and mortar sales and marketing. Facebook organized the 9 pop-up stores to be part of the Market at Macy's. The Market at Macy's concept debuted earlier this year to provide space and exposure to small brands. You can see our episode from February 28th, 2018. We did an entire story about that. The Facebook stores will feature goods from 100 small business and online brands which sell apparel, accessories, beauty, entertainment, experiences, decorative home, stationery, technology, and gifts, according to a Macy's press release. The good news for the merchants is that they'll keep all the revenue generated from sales. Facebook footed the bill that Macy's usually charges for the pop-up market customers. The store's design mimics the Facebook experience by showcasing products in newsfeed post-themed displays, complete with a like button. While Facebook does not take any revenue from the experiment, it could use the exposure to convince small businesses to spend more money advertising on Facebook and Instagram, as well as gathering valuable data about these customers. The 9 pop-ups will operate until February 2nd in the Market at Macy's in New York, Pittsburgh, Atlanta, Fort Lauderdale, San Antonio, Las Vegas, Los Angeles, San Francisco, and Seattle. Facebook will also run a big ad campaign of its own in New York City's Grand Central Station for the next 3 weeks to promote the pop-ups, featuring 600 ad units with 36 designs across 115 locations in the public transportation hub. Facebook will also run ads for the stores on its app and Instagram and provide the merchants with complimentary digital ad design from Facebook's Creative Shop. This is great for whoever gets involved in this.
Yeah, it is.
Lots of free advertising. It's amazing.
Yeah, it's kind of like, let us put all the free things into free things. I mean...
Yeah, and you know Facebook, they're all about the data, so it doesn't really cost them anything in comparison.
No, I mean it's an easy ad for them, right? It's not going to cost them that much, and you know doing these pop-ups and these physical things is they need to do those more and more, right? Being a good tool for advertisers and you know e-commerce is the play for Facebook.
Yeah, and they're having a problem. Their growth has been decelerating, so they're really going to lean on, especially they're going to lean on Instagram advertising. I think all signs seem to be pointing that Facebook is looking for its future to be bright with Instagram as they go and rip off every other app that's out there.
Because they don't know what else to do.
Yeah, they don't know what else to do. The news feed and everything, just Facebook. I mean, I'm not going to go on a rant, but social media is such a garbage fire lately. But I think, you know, and I've always said this, I'm a big fan of Instagram. I think Instagram is kind of the nice space right now. It's not as angry as all the other places in social media.
It's not as angry.
So this is great for Macy's. We applauded this when this first came out. They're looking for that experiential retail because we all know that department stores, like people don't want the same old department stores anymore. And Macy's being flexible about their spacing and doing uniqueness, you know, will drive more foot traffic. It's great for these smaller brands because they get good exposure. I really like the Market at Macy's concept. And the fact that Facebook got involved and are helping out these brands is pretty awesome for them.
Yeah. I mean, they're not the only ones that's doing it, right? There's a few startups out there that are actually popping up doing this, like Bulletin, right?
So what's the other one? Right. We talked about Bulletin.
And then somebody else was doing it.
Right. Right. And there was one story I have kind of filed away. There's a place in Brooklyn that's doing it. So there's a lot of these. They take a big space and cut it up and right. Rotate it and do the museum, the gallery curation type thing, which I think is great. I think that's really great for discovery. I think it's great for consumers. It gives these small brands a leg up and you've got a small, let's just say, I don't know, beard oil or hot sauce or something. And you get tapped to be in one of these experiential things. You're suddenly selling your goods to a metropolitan audience in a store that you could never, ever, ever afford.
Well, yeah. I mean, something like Bulletin, obviously it's a boutique and then you have those boutique-y things and people do care about local, but Facebook is doing it with Macy's. Inside of Macy's, especially you doing holidays, that place is crowded like crazy.
Yeah, and we talked about like
all shelves, and first of all, it's Facebook, right? So everybody's going to go check it out. So whoever is in that store is winning.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Just the curiosity factor of what's this, a Facebook store? Because well, Facebook sell? What are they going to sell me? Like, but,
right?
But that they're running this big ad campaign in the Grand Central Station. You've got all those tourists coming through there, and you know what they do during Christmas season? They do the what do you call it? The circuit. We got to go to Macy's. We got to go to Rockefeller Center. So you know, people coming through the train station are going to be bombarded by this advertising. And like I said, these small brands are getting this for free. So it's really, I mean, whoever was lucky enough to get involved in this experiment, I hope they capitalize on it. And of course, Facebook will use their data, but you know, who cares?
Exactly.
Exactly. All right. Pretty cool. So it's the market at Macy's. It'll be running until February 2nd. You can check our website, ecommerceminute.co for locations. Do you have anything else, Bart?
That is it.
All right, that's your e-commerce minute for today. We'll see you on the internet tomorrow. That's it for today's show. If you like the show, do us a favor and subscribe or leave us a review on iTunes. And don't forget, you can now listen to the e-commerce minute on your Amazon device. Just add e-commerce minute to your flash briefing. And finally, if you have a comment or suggestion or just want to say hi, find us on social media at Sumo Heavy.